Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to the channel. Now in this tutorial series, yes, it is a series and this is the first video in the series, we are going to talk about validation. Yes, that is correct, text field validation in Swift. So without further ado, let's get right into it. Okay, let me just show you what the testing project is all about. So let's build and run. And we are calling this Regex Mania because this validation is based on Regex. Now Regex is quite hard to understand, but we are going to handle this in this video. So it says type in your age. So let's type in not an age, so Alex. Not a valid age, and that is correct. Now let's type in 12. It is a valid age, great. Now how does this really work? Well, we want to have a two-digit number, and that is what we are looking for here. Maybe you want to have an age that is greater than 18, that can be added too, but this is just for validation. If I type in test here, this is not a valid age. Now, this is what we are going to implement today in this video. In the next videos, we are going to implement validation of emails, passwords, and websites. So go ahead and do be on the lookout for the next videos in this episode series. Okay, so what we are going to do now is start from the starter project. Start from the starter project. That is really funny. Now, what you need to do is go ahead and click the link down in the description. You will be taken to our YouTube resources page where you will be able to find the link to our GitHub repository. And once you clone or download that repository, you will find yourself with this structure. Well, you will not have the pods and the pod file lock, but you will have a pod file. Now, all you have to do is update the pod file. So open up terminal here. Let's make that a little bigger, like so. And all you have to do is type in cd a space and grab the root folder of your project and hit drag and drop it onto the terminal window and hit return. Now, finally, you need to type in pod update, and that will update all of the pods in your project. I won't do this because it takes quite a while, but once you do that, you will have all of your pods installed. Well, there is only one pod, and that is tiny constraints, and of course, that is for constraining our views. I always use tiny constraints in my projects. Go ahead and take a look at my video on how to use tiny constraints on the channel. Okay, and now, once you open that up, you will find yourself with this structure. We have an app delegate that has our root view controller inside the navigation controller. Here we have our root view controller with the text field and the label and a navigation item title and a handle text change, and that is the selector of our text field. Okay, and we will print out the text. And I have an extensions file here. You can take a look at the Regex expressions cheat sheet here, and it will come really handy to understand all of the regexes that we are going to create in these episodes. Okay, now what we are going to do now is let's just build and run and see what happens. Well, basically we will have our text field with type in your age, and that is it. If we type in anything, so hello there, you will find that all of this is typed out into, it is printed out into the console. And that is it. Now, let's get down to business and create our regexes. So we want to validate this text field's text. And that text field text is a string. So now that we want to validate this text that is a string, we might as well create an extension for it. So let's go and select the extensions.swift file, and go ahead and create a string extension here. And that is it. We want to have a function. Let's call this function something like, and it will return a bool value. And that is it. Once you do have this, of course we have to have a return value. Let's add this to true for now so we can get rid of this error. So if we go back to our root view controller and let's say if text dot is well, I need to hit command B so we get the completions here. So is valid, then let's print out valid text. Okay, and otherwise it is not valid. So that is what we are going to add in here. And of course, we want to have more validation types. So let's create an enum here of validity type. Okay, enum, there we go. Enum validity type. And the first case is age. And in the next videos, we are going to talk about emails. So we might as well type in here email, just so we know that we have more than one cases. I will comment this out. We will talk about that in the next video. Okay, now we want to check if is valid, and we are going to add in here a validity type. And it will be of type validity type. I will make this a small v. And now we need to return something according to this validity type. Okay, now let us just take a look at how Regex works. And we are going to return here an NS predicate. And we are going to use this format with arguments. Okay, and format, the format will be some sort of string. So let's create a format here. Let format equals, and I will add in here a empty string just for now. And the argument is actually the regex. So let's create our regex here. And I will make this a variable, of course, again, another empty string, because the variable will be changed according to our validity type. And what we want to do next is type in a dot evaluate with and self, because self is the string that we are adding in here. Okay. Now it says the regex was never mutated. So let's fix this by adding here a switch statement. Switch, and value is validity type. And the pattern for now it is age and dot age. And that's all to it right now. We will add in later on for email, password and website. But for now the age regex will be, so let's type in here regex equals to and some other value. Now let's talk about the format and the regex. Now the format, and I will need to copy and paste this because I don't want to have typos here. Now the format will be like so. So it does match the regex. Okay, let me just paste that in. I will try to write this out. Let me just, I believe it is like 0 till 9 and let's say 2 till 20 or something like that, 6 or rather yeah, 2 till 2. So what does this mean? And as you can see, I'm stumbling with, and I will really make sure that we do have the correct regex, and that is it. I will just copy and paste it here, and let me just explain what this does. Well, basically we want to have characters ranging from 0 till 9, and the minimum character count, like the strings count, is set to be true 2, and the maximum count for the string has to be 2, like it has to be a 2-digit number, and that is the regex here. And for ease of use, I will create another enum here. And that will be called regex and the case, and it will be a string enum. And for the case age, I will just copy and paste, cut and paste all of this here. And for the regex now, I will call upon regex.age.rowValue. Okay, let's hit command B so we know that nothing has been written wrong. And it says it's missing argument in parameter, and that is correct. Let's add that in here. And string validity type, and that is dot age. Okay, and let us just go ahead and take a look at this one. And I believe this is quite okay. And we are done with the extension. So let's talk about the root view controller's handle text change. Now here we have the text. And first of all, let's create a validity type constant. Or rather yet, let's put it out all the way up here. And it will be of type string.validityType, and it will have the value of age. And that's it. So we will be able to change this to email and so on with a really clarified way. Okay, and now all we have to do here is change this to validity type. But I don't want to have only an if statement. We want to check for our validity type according to their, let's say, email or age value. So what we want to do here is type in here switch and validity type. And in case of dot age, we want to do the following, and I will remove the default value here because this switch statement will be exhausted. Now, let's take a look at if the text is valid, and let's just cut this out and paste it in there. Then we want to add this text to our label, but in a way that, let's say, text is valid. So we want to have our labels text to say valid, and we are not going to type in here age or email or something like that. We are going to use the validity type. So validity type, and that's it. Otherwise, we are going to set the labels text to be not valid, and age or email and so on. So that will be there. Or rather yet, come to think about it, we are not using this age property. So, and let me just cut this out and simply get rid of this switch statement. I just made up my mind. That's how coding is. And one last thing that we might want to add here, here in the placeholder of our text view, we have this age written out in row string. So what we want to add here again is the validity type. So hopefully that wasn't that hard. So let's build and run and test this out. Okay, type in your age. Works really well with the age. And let's type in Alex and not valid age. Rather, let's change this to not a valid age. Let's build and run again. So Alex, not a valid age. Let's say 4, it's still not a valid age. And let's say 25, valid age, great. But let's say if you wanted to type in like 367, well, that is not a valid age. Or what about 99? Still a valid age. 100, well, not a valid age. Not many people get to have 100 years of their life. Okay, so that is validation of our age. Now, in the next video, you are going to talk about email validation. As you can see here, we have our regex. It is pretty simple, but for the email we need to make some complicated stuff with the regex. Go ahead and take a look at the emailregex.com cheat sheet. Just simply hit command and click on the link here. And hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell. And if you like this video, go ahead and comment down below, what are you using validations for? And as always, I will see you in the next one.